Same. So it's going to be a mirror matchup here on the side of Haven. Of course, Vision Strikers starting off here on the attacking side. Attack all around, contrary to the name, on the defensive end here. So we'll see how they can get started as the drone actually only scouting the Omen, but they know that this Omen tends to be playing over alone, just stopping any aggressive rotation. So let's see if they react to that appropriately. We do have three members of Attack All Around currently stacked on A. A little bit of crouching there coming out from the jet, but we'll see here. As Vision Strikers instead might just take their time here, lurk through B, maybe push through Garage. This is very, very normal for this map. Gives you so much opportunity to kind of just go wherever you please.
Yeah, I actually really like the setup that AAA have here, because if anybody decides to push through A long, then they can get slowed down by Breach's Flashpoint, allowing both Jet and Cypher to actually rotate around and actually get some free kills. On the other side, for a C site, they have the Omen as well as the Sova. Sova initially starting off on C, making sure that any C-long pushes aren't going to be as effective, but I love the way that AAA uses their pings to kind of indicate to their teammates where they need to be at what time, and it gives us casters a good perspective of what they're thinking about.
Yep, indeed. As AAA now kicking it off, they realize that the spike is now A. Vision Strikers kind of just waltzing on in, not finding any resistance whatsoever, as they will now find two quite close. Down the aggressive now. Oh, the ghost shot's not connecting here, splitting the gap, shooting left and right of the head before actually connecting. As Stacks getting aggressive, will find both. Beautiful stuff there. Out from the enemy breach as nice sprays
this
there.
Is great.
PTC gonna make it a 2v2.
This is really great. They actually did a delay push. They didn't actually have to do it at the same time, but they did so anyway. The shock arrow just to make sure that default plants aren't going to be defuses are going to be impossible here, but that frenzy making sure that it makes quick work of P.
Try and hold C here. Flash as we should see him fall indeed. Sprayed down by the perfect double peek now as Vision Strikers move into C site.
Vision Strikers making quick work of AAA once again, getting on to see through the smoke once again. Congrarid is going to be going down so quickly. King making sure that that area is completely safe, bothering to shoot through smoke to buy as much time as possible for the team. Not like they actually need the time, more so to slow down the push to get that great setup as they rotate both Breach as well as the Jet pushing through Garage.
Yeah, pretty much. Just flexing on them at this point here. Vision Strikers, they know that AAA is going to make a play here. They might as well. It's a full eco, so they should be careful to avoid any exit frags. AAA will only find one before the trade, and that's going to be Stacks. Now in Garage, and going to have to go for another eco as PTC now lurking quite aggressively. Knows there's one, at least two now pushing through Garage as the sprays. Oh no! PTC not checking the right area as King actually trading away Conqueror, who was hoping to try and get a revenge kill, but RB as well picking off Jenny, holding in B site. AAA, they're just falling apart here, Gideon.
I'm just trying to make a conscious effort to be thinking, okay, this is Vision Strikers. This isn't the absolute most devastating teams on the planet here, like a SWAT team, because these guys, if this was real life, it's really hard to tell the difference. They are covering these angles almost perfectly, almost no holes in their play, no area unchecked, no angle untouched.
Yeah, indeed, is here. Retake attempt out from AAA, but no chance there. Getting flashed yet again here as the one remaining member, Ascetics, just looking to hold on to that rifle, give his team any sort of advantage they can. But Vision Strikers, again, just taking a commanding lead here early on, 3-0.
I don't know about you, but are they getting cleaner and cleaner every single time they touch this battlefield? Like, Haven, every single time we've seen Vision Strikers on Haven, they are looking better, and they are covering their angles as if they were
one. RB will peek that, not finding anyone as we're on board now with Conqueror, but RB is going to get a second flash there. There's a lot of utility used there just to be able to get a single kill onto the Cypher, as it will be now a push towards the A site out from Vision Strikers.
I mean, this is going to be looking tough as they've already gotten onto site here, but unfortunately they can't even get the flashpoint down on time. Breach is going to be going down. The rest of the team coming through spawn. Jet trying to be her best, waiting for her that time. Tailwind in. That's not going to be great. She has no means of escape until she gets two kills. Sova going to be sitting down on Heaven side, buying time and giving some pressure, focus, getting the attention of the enemy's fire towards him.
Yeah, Vision Strikers are going to be very keen to eliminate the rifle here that Ascetics is currently holding onto, as he will be hit by the fault line. It looks like AAA, they're going to go for the high-risk play here, going for that double take here against the five members of Vision Strikers getting sprayed there. I believe they did actually tag Sova once through the wall. The shots continuing to ring on in. Ah, there we go. Conqueror getting being picked off. Walled by Zest. He's looking for another one. It's Vision Strikers. Will back off. AAA making the call to save. Not giving each other, giving each other the respect to not even be approaching each other in the general direction. Not looking for extra frag.
Spy Cam's going to be taken out here. They know somebody's in garage, but that first pick off from B is going to be down. B main. Ooh, a dangerous spot to be in.
I think I do see the double operator strat coming through from attack all around here, but they've already lost one, so that's going to make it a little bit easier to try and hold. You can see that they've completely relinquished control of A for now, but Vision Striker is continuing to play this one very, very patiently. They know they're up against a full buy here on a map like Haven, even though it is more attacker-sided. They don't want to give up a single round here. It looks like they're playing for maybe even the flawless, but attack all around, they're not giving it up quite yet, as we will see Ginny on board now with her now, with the operator lurking through, looking to try and turn wide here for a short, unable to connect the jet, though, hitting the leg there of the Cypher, who will drop the hat in return. PTC straight into the wall he goes, and put down by Glow. Oh goodness, Gideon, this one is starting to get ugly.
It's already ugly as it is. I mean, Vision Strikers just making sure they're winning every single fight, even though it's not technically supposed to be in their favor. AAA right now definitely dropped the ball on this round. I can't say the same for the other rounds because they definitely had the right idea, but at the end of the day, Vision Strikers just coming up on top.
Yeah, it's both operators now out of the hands of AAA. Very, very expensive round out from them, and now they're going to be forced to buy a second time as Congrid trying to hold in garage. Vision Strikers, they're looking for these exit frags. RB running around, will swing wide and still land the shot onto Ascetics, as now he will be scouted running back towards the site. Congrid still lurking, just walking, but it's going to be RB unable to finally go for it instead, where instead Ascetics is currently waiting, now backs up into Cubby, but prepared to potentially get a pick here or two, but they're going to check the angle. Oh no, they pulled out the knife instead. That's going to allow Stax to drop a king. Finds two in return now, picking up the kill on the Congrid into the site they already are, and Spike being planted inside the cyber cage.
This is going to be a little bit more of an interesting climb because it's going to be slightly blocked by on C-Long, but again, AAA, can you take it out here? Can the Bucky manage to get it? He gets one, but he can't get that second one, unfortunately. At least, you know, the Bucky has his profit.
It does have
rotations to try and get those hard reads, which Vision Strikes. Oh, wow! What a shot through the wall, Aesthetics. He is tired of Glow.
Yeah, indeed. Yeah, he is. That's been the annoying member to deal with. They're going to drop back. Nicely done here. Oh, no. Oh, he's got a good Congrid. Okay, thank God. He redeems himself instantly. He says, no. I saw what I saw. As now they're going to be pulling out the Hunter's Fury. Congrid, though, doing quite nicely. Aesthetics is the one. They're actually going to be pushing down C-Long. That's going to be Zest easily lining him up. The operator shot. And another C push. Congo will get the kill into RB. Vicious Strikers. There have it. A 2v4 scenario coming through now. They will be using that Omen ult. Now Ginny with the clutch running on in, I believe he's
manpower to muscle their way through the garage.
It will be a B push. They've heard plenty of footsteps now. Aesthetics, though, on the money there with his crosshairs as Congrid opening up the round onto one. They've seen one cross as well. Astax finishing off Congrid, though, trading him away. Nice TP as the spike will be planted there. Oh, good Rolling Thunder, but no one actually in sight. It will allow them to enter, but they're going to be playing for the mid hold. The Zest with the operator shot does well to start off this spike defense.
This is really rough. This is really rough. What can they really do? They're going to have to expend some utility to get out of garage side, but here comes the counter ult from Vision Strikers. This is really frustrating to watch because even if I was in AAA's position, I wouldn't really know how to get it, how to get them off.
Yeah, it's so difficult. They're not even contesting from site. They're just contesting from mid, but the Lurker's unable to actually get through their defensives means that it's pretty much an impossible take for them. They're going to be happy to settle here. Although we see King on board now with him. The operator shot going to miss. He's going to be able to find that instant one shot there as PTC at least getting a trade onto Stax. Should be at least a push. It looks like they will be bringing it back now. RB opening up. I believe that was A site? Yes, it was. Mm-hmm. They find the man in A sewers there. We don't manage to catch it, but RB still ready to continue pushing on.
30 Cypher seconds
in
left.
Heaven on the camera as in they go. Nice shot there. Plenty of smokes actually dropping down with 25. Now make that 20 seconds to plant this spike. Aesthetics, though, rotating around as it looks like to be rotating through B, but they did hear him. He's able to win the initial trade now as they continue to push. Aesthetics finding a second shot now on his Zest before trading away King as well. It's a 2v4. There's going to be the Cypher ult. RB. Oh, the spike will be killed just as it was going down. They might not have enough time to replant it. PTC CC going on through, needs to kill the Spike carry, will manage to do it, but the Spike has been planted now, it's a 1v1 scenario, Knives out, RB, is he going to be able to take the round as he will be able to get that Tailwind away, faking already the defuse for one, he will be now poking on through as RB backing all the way off, he knows that he's got a massive advantage here, Gideon, but might he not know that AAA continuing to now swing around by PTC, able to clutch the round for his team, picking up the Operator, and if you
deal with that Flashpoint as well as, as well as the plotline can be difficult. Can they get that initial kill? Yes, they do onto PTC. That Hunter, the Hunter's ult coming in pretty hard from Silva. My words are just not coming out of my mouth as well, so take it away.
Yeah, they are able to set up the post plan here very, very nicely. AAA now, they're faced with a pretty difficult decision of 4v5. They can't really afford to give more rounds away here to Vision Strikers. They've already got a 5-round advantage. They also, as well, can't really afford to do really much about the eco situation as they will drop one. That's the initial trade. The member in hell has been killed, but Zest immediately returning now. As Ascetics into the site, Ginny as well will be able to make this a 1v2 scenario. We've seen Ginny with some clutch rounds. Can she get another one here as that spike continuing to tick away? Going for the fault line now as Stacks rotating around the box, but Zest holding the angle from a long later into our first half.
I mean, don't get me wrong. I absolutely love Vision Strikers, but they are just winning so hard, and the fashion of which that they are winning on is so, so impressive. I can't help but feel really, really excited, and yet so, so hurt every time I see Vision Strikers get another pickoff onto the side of AAA because they have worked so hard to get here.
That is true, but if you're a South Korean fan here or a fan of Vision Strikers, you're overjoyed with every single kill, right? Two sides to every coin here, but this is a very one-sided coin as we flip it again and again and again, but still it's 2-1 here for every single round that AAA have won in favor of Vision Strikers, but they will be holding here. Ginny with the Bucky is going to be looking for any exit frags, but unlikely to see Vision Strikers peak for more. They're still playing this one cool, calm, and collected. Some very clean and disciplined Valorant.
And this is the way it should be done. And so far, they've been doing a very good job at just holding these angles every single time. AAA, on the other hand, are a little slow on the rotation sometimes just because of the mind games Vision Strikers are really incorporating into this Grand Finals.
Indeed. As that'll be the ninth round. Now one final round for AAA to try and at least get attack all around. Here's the we hear the Hunter's Fury coming on through. Glow though already onto two stacks. Oh my goodness, it's already a 2v5 here, Gideon. And they're continuing to push. Ginny will at least close the gap down to three for the five for the four make. Oh my goodness, for the 4v2 here as they're trying to at least get themselves a little bit more of an advantage.
Do you see what I mean? It gets to everyone once Vision Strikers are in this oppressive position. It's hard to get your words out. Oh, he finds another one. RB just holding these angles rock solid, doesn't even flinch. They have the confidence and they are on the hunt as Vision Strikers rotate towards that B side. Yeah. They've got every one of these angles and rotations on lock. Ascetics, he finds the first one. They're going to be planting on C. It's a 1v3 situation, and it's going to be a tough one to get out of.
Yeah, Vision Strikers, they're so calm, cool, and collected. They just play so disciplined. They realize there's no real reason. They hear the enemies rotating towards A. They leave RB there to just contest him, get that easy kill there, make it a 1v3. Sure, he's able to trade him back eventually, but spike down in C, and we're likely to see the round end. Here is King AO just waiting. They heard that footsteps now, so they're going to back up into Garage. He could find a really good angle here now as they're not going to be looking to contest him very hard. Now arrows raining down, shock bolts, or both connect here, but Omen, he is going to stand his ground and fight with that one. He will get paranoid and flashes. In comes the entry now. King finding the first pick and the second one before Ginny's able to trade him away. Now RB finding the kill onto the enemy. Jet has a look at Ginny trying to do whatever they can. It gets three kills, but unfortunately cannot get all five for the side as Vision Strikers will be able to get on that spike. Fortune here for the South Korean squad of Vision Strikers. Just excellent stuff. It's being a bit aggressive. RB able to find one as Zest actually as well is going to be able to trade another one away. Trying to get aggressive here. They're actually going to lose out in this instance though as AAA, again, stacks though onto Ginny who's trying to go through A short, I believe now. Here's the footsteps of one. A great double peek there as he will be shot. Great coordination there from attack all around, but now Glow into the site, finding the headshot with one onto the Ghost. It's going to be just PTC with the Sheriff. He sees the man up in hell, but he's been scouted as well and plenty of enemies closing the gap. A great headshot, a 1v1 scenario, but but King from A Sewers able to look there on the ankle. But just to give you some quick stats on map number one before we get underway, Stacks, 25% headshot rate, King, 26, and Glow with that 29% headshot rate here as we see now PTC trying to hold on to his corner here in B, but Stacks running through the smoke here out from Garage. Spike already going down here to the side of Triple A's. They will not get an open kill onto Stacks.
Shock arrows coming through as well. Beacon Hunter is not looking too great as they continue to push on through. Can they finally kill Aesthetics? He finds one. Can he get another one? It's a 5v2 situation, and this is going to be the call. For the first time in this particular matchup, Vision Strikers are going to have to save.
Yeah, they don't want to throw this one away whatsoever. They could kind of just go for the YOLO play, but they just are playing so safely as King, able to trade away one. Nearly that second kill here with the Spectre, forcing them back Zest as well here, making it a 2v3, so decent eco damage done to AAA as well. Of course, every round here from them is going to be a full buy, so they're going to be doing very nicely here to try and save a bit more money, as they will be able to claim a third round for themselves. One more than they have here in the previous match up, and Strikers, though, just ready to face something yet again as Andre's Fury looking to pick one off there. The back and forth, nice juke. He will be able to survive for now. That might be the deciding factor here as Vision Strikers still stacked outside of C long, but they're now into Garage's King, getting picked off now by PTC. AAA continue to go on in as Glow with the headshot onto WannaFly. Great take here out from AAA. It's a 1v4 scenario as Zest with the operator, and it's going to be a very difficult hold here.
Very lightning fast reactions coming in from AAA. If they're committing to getting this bomb onto site, they are hard committing, and now they are going on the hunt for the last member of Vision Strikers to give themselves that confidence they need to make that happen. Zest, he finds one onto Kong Garrett here. Unfortunately, he's going to be the first to be picked off from the up. That flick was so close.
Yeah, PTC is going to be scouted there by the recon.
Don't do it.
Might be scouted again. Going to smoke off, but oh, come on. Is he going to go for a Zest? They're playing with him here a little bit. Another recon bolt traded. In fact, they want to be able to get rid of this operator, chasing him down now into heaven, going for the gun. Yes! Going to land the shot, though. Up in heaven, it's mad. My domain.
Respect. I don't even watch her op. Get that out of here.
I just wanted to knife you, man. I wasn't even here for the op.
That was great. Definitely a great move. But it does show that AAA are willing to make these moves even from behind. The flashpoint does kick. But now the Hunter's Fury is going to be pushing out from the backside here as they rotate from B into A. Once again, AAA really lightning fast pushes.
Yeah, they've only managed to find one, though, as Glow back in. Up he goes now. Zest with no operator this time, as we're going to switch over to our drone shot. Up in heaven, two members holding on to hell, but RB getting the pick onto Aesthetics here. We also got one there. There's going to be the Rolling Thunder coming on in, but it's already a 2v3 scenarios. They're going to be jumped up. Oh, the spray not connecting. Oh, it doesn't matter, though, but Jenny, the last remaining member, will be traded down by Glow, who drops down from heaven, and that will be map number two going the way of Vision Strikers. Two